Hi friends, this is Hemant Kumar Reddy. Today we are discussing about helical antenna. So first of all, we are discussing about introduction, construction and working, radiation pattern and advantages of helical antenna and disadvantages of helical antenna. Finally, we discuss the applications of helical antenna. Let's move on to the introduction of helical antenna. Helical antenna is a type of antenna that is designed using conducting wire and it is constructed in the shape of helix. So, if the helical antenna is constructed by using one conducting wire, it is called monofiller. By using two or more conducting wires, it is called bifiller or quadfiller. So now, let's see how helical antenna is operated. And the helical antenna is operated in the range of 300 MHz to 3 GHz. Let's move on to the construction and working. Helical antenna is constructed by using conducting wire. A thick copper wire is wound in the form of helix and it is used in conjunction with the metal plate. That metal plate is ground plated. The copper wire is connected to the ground plated and it is wounded in the form of helix, and the coaxial cable is added with the copper wire. The diameter of the copper wire is D and the diameter of helix conductor is small d, and this is the axial length, total length is axial length, and the spacing between one turn to another turn is s, and finally length of the turn is, this is the length of the turn, so it is l, and the small l is feed length. This is the feeding wire. The distance between this and this is feeding length. For a better understanding, let us take a helical model. This is the helical model. So it is a diameter of the helix. It is the diameter of the helical conducting wire. It is a capital D. It is denoted by capital D. It means the whole diameter of the helix. It is the diameter of helix conductor. It means it is small d. The spacing between the two wounding wires is s. And the one turn, complete one turn, it is denoted by L. Now let's move on to the designing parameters. The radiation depends on D. It means diameter of the helix. S, it is the turn spacing. Alpha, it is the pitch angle. C, it is the circumference of the helix. And circumference C is equals to pi D. Let's L equals to length of the helix. L equals to root of s square plus c square. Now we simplifying this. L equals to root of s square plus c square. In the form of c square, we are substituting pi d. This is the length of the helix. Now move on to the pitch angle. It is denoted by alpha, and go through this equation. Tan alpha equals to s by c. S equals to pi by d. In the place of c, we are substituting pi by d. Then by some solving this equation, alpha equals to tan inverse of s by pi d. Let us move on to the radiation pattern. In helical antenna, there are two types of modes of operation are there. Normal mode operation, axial mode operation. Here, normal mode operation, it conducts the radiation pattern is in bidirectional. Normal mode operation, radiation pattern is bidirectional. In axial mode operation, the radiation pattern is unidirectional. It means same like as a broadside array, the radiation pattern same as the end fire array. Here the radiation pattern is unidirection. It means it radiates long distance. So we consider in helical antenna, we consider the axial mode operation. So we are taking axial mode operation in helical antenna. This is a major lobe. This is a minor lobes. Move on to the advantages of helical antenna. Helical antenna having a simple construction and it operates high directional behavior and the wide operating bandwidth. Helical antenna operates in ultra high frequency and very high frequencies. Now moving to the disadvantages of helical antenna. Antenna is a larger and requires more space, and the helical antenna efficiency decreases with the number of turns is increases. And finally move to the applications of helical antenna. Helical antenna is used in radio astronomy and it is also used in satellite communication. In satellite communication, moon to earth communication we are using a helical antenna.